Use the graph of f of x equals the absolute value of x plus 3 to find f of negative 1 and f of 2. For which values of x is f of x equal to 5? Then find the domain and range of f. We'll start by finding f of negative 1 and f of 2. To find f of negative 1, we're looking for the function value corresponding to an x value of negative 1. If we look at negative 1 on the x-axis, and we move up to see which point on the graph has an x-coordinate of negative 1, we can see that it's this point here, and it has a y-coordinate of 4. So when x is negative 1, we can see that y, or f of x, is 4. So f of negative 1 is equal to 4. Similarly, we can find f of 2 by looking at 2 on the x-axis and moving up to see what the y-coordinate is of the point that has an x-coordinate of 2. In this case, the y-coordinate is 5, so we know that f of 2 equals 5. The next question asks, for which value or values of x is f of x equal to 5? Remember that f of x is just another way to represent y, so we're looking for the points on this graph that have a y-coordinate of 5. To do that, we look at 5 on the y-axis, and we look to the left and the right to see which points have a y-coordinate of 5. There are two of them. One of them is here, and that occurs when x is 2. The other one is here, and that occurs when x equals negative 2. So the two values where f of x equals 5 occur when x equals 2 and x equals negative 2. So we can say f of x equals 5 when x equals 2 or x equals negative 2. Just a little thing here, we usually use the word or when we're listing multiple solutions or multiple values, because we use and when we talk about systems of equations, when we're looking for two things to be true at the exact same time. But x can't be 2 and negative 2 at the same time, so just as a technicality, we use the word or in this scenario. Now lastly, we're asked to find the domain and range of f. For the domain, I'm just going to use blue to be consistent with how I've done things in previous videos. The domain is going to be the set of x values that are allowed in this function. And the way that we can find this visually is by taking any point on the graph and projecting it down onto the x-axis to see which x values correspond to points on our graphs. Now we can see here, as we project on the right-hand side down to the x-axis, that we are getting all of the positive values of x in our domain. And this is going to continue to the right because we know that this function is going to continue going to the right, and we're going to keep hitting these positive x values. As we look to the left, we're going to get the negative values of x. And because the graph continues on indefinitely, we're going to keep going to the left all the way. So we're also going to have the negative values of x as part of the domain. And of course, we also have 0 because we do have a point with an x coordinate of 0. So in this case, we have all real numbers in our domain. And we write this as the set of numbers x such that x is a real number. Good. Let's look at the range. I have been doing this in red, so to stay consistent, I'm going to continue that. The range is the set of y values that work in our function, the set of output values. So what we're going to do for any point on our graph, we're going to project it to the y-axis. And so if we look at these points on the right, and we project them onto the y-axis, we're getting all of the values above 3. And we also get 3 itself, because we do have a point 0, 3 that has a y-coordinate of 3. Now, if we project the points on the left-hand side of the graph onto the y-axis, we get these same points where we get these same numbers above 3. And if we look at the graph, there is no part of the graph that's below y equals 3. We don't have any values where y is less than 3. So in our range, it's going to be the set of y values such that y is greater than or equal to 3. This is slightly different from some of the other examples we've seen. In the past, we've seen y or x is greater than or equal to 0. But it is possible with different graphs that our range will be y is greater than or equal to some other number. It could be less than or equal to some other number. There's lots of possibilities, and that's why we're looking at these example problems, to get an idea of the different scenarios we can find ourselves in.